Hello students, I'm Dr. Aisha Siddiqua, Assistant Professor in Government First Grade College, Tumkur. This video is for BSc students who have taken chemistry as an optional for the first semester studying under Tumkur University for the session 14 of Atomic Structure. In this video, you're going to learn about the rules for filling the electrons in various orbitals. And the rules are of Bohr principle, relative energies of atomic orbitals, and also another rule, that's Hund's rule, and also Pauli's principles. These are the topics which you are going to learn in this particular video. In the previous session, we learned about the shapes of s, p, d atomic orbitals and also a little bit about the nodal planes. Now, in this present video, we shall be learning how to write the electronic configuration for various elements. Periodic table is having numerous elements for which we may have to write the electronic configuration, which helps us to define various properties, the reactions the elements may undergo, etc. So while writing the electronic configuration, we may have to follow certain rules, and these rules are of Bohr principles. We also must know about the relative energies of the atomic orbitals, Hund's rule, and also Pauli's exclusion principle. Let's start off with Aufbau principle. The statement goes as this. In an atom, the ground state of an atom are an ion. Electrons fill atomic orbitals of the lower energy first, then they go and occupy the higher energy levels. So the bottom line is, while filling the electrons, the lower energy orbitals are filled first before the higher energy orbitals are filled. To explain this principle, Aufbau gave us one example where we have to write. We'll take the laser pointer here. We'll take the blue color. So, laser pointer, Aufbau principle. So we have the energy levels here. We start with the lowest one and we are going upwards towards 8. And here this is indicating the azimuthal quantum number. We have different shapes of the orbitals. So L is equal to 0 all refer to the s orbitals. 1 refers to the p orbitals. 2 for the d orbitals and 3 f orbitals. So we first write down 1s, 2s to be almost equal. They will be almost equal, slightly in the they'll be varying. So if we write these arrows through each one of them such that they pass through the same line, this is how the Aufbau principle is written and helps us to write the electronic configuration and also show how the electrons are fit in different orbitals. The 1s orbitals will have the lowest energy, so the electrons are fit in this first, then the 2s, then we go on to the 2p, 3s, from here we'll come on to this 3p, 4s. Likewise, these arrows, as the arrows move in that direction, we have to follow and fill the orbitals. 1s can take up 2 electrons, 2s also will take up 2 electrons, then 2p takes up 6 electrons. Likewise, you have to go on filling the electrons in these orbitals. The next thing that we have to remember is Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. If 2 or more degenerate orbitals are available, for example, if we have 2p orbitals, especially the 2p orbitals we are talking about, degenerate refers to the same energy. As I said, degenerate refers to the same energy. If these orbitals are available, one electron goes into each of these orbitals, that is, they're half filled first, and then the complete filling takes place, the pairing takes place later on. So Hund's rule says that we should have the maximum multiplicity, that is, the electron should have should be oriented in the same spin first. Once all the spins are occupied, like all the orbitals are occupied with the same spinning electrons, then the pairing will start. So here you can see here for element having atomic number of 8, 1s fills first with the opposite pairing, 2s also fills. But here, these three are degenerate, 2p orbitals are degenerate. For such orbitals, first the lowest energy, that is here, they are singly occupied with the same spin, then they will be paired up. Okay, thus the electrons fill each orbital singly with their spins in the parallel direction before any orbital gets the second electron in the anti-parallel direction.
Yeah, electrons are distributed among the orbitals of the subshells in such a way that it gives maximum number of unpaired electrons with the same spin, that is parallel spin, in the same direction. Pairing of electrons in the orbitals belonging to the same subshell does not take place until each orbital belonging to that subshell has got one electron each. Now let's take one example here, which very nice. If an atom is having electronic configuration of 7, then it will be singly occupied like this. We cannot fill it likewise, wherein one lowest energy orbital is having opposite spins and leaving this empty. This is the wrong way of representation. If there are 8 electrons, 1s and 2s orbitals, they get filled with 4 electrons, and the remaining 4 have to be filled like this, wherein there is maximum spin multiplicity. That means they are first singly occupied. So this is the wrong way of representation of writing the orientation of the electrons. Here we can say that they are already paired up, and this is not right. This is the wrong way of representing the electronic configuration. Now the next thing that we have to remember is Pauli's exclusion principle. The statement says that no two electrons can be identified by the same set of quantum numbers. So you have two electrons and they have similar quantum numbers. At least one of the quantum number has to be different, and most of the time that different quantum number will be in the spin state, that is the spin quantum number. So in other words, only two electrons can exist in the same orbital, and these electrons must and should have opposite spins. One will be having a positive half spin, or we can say that it is going in the anti-clockwise direction, and then one will be in the clockwise direction. They'll be spinning in the clockwise direction. This is known as Pauli's exclusion principle. It excludes the spins having being similar. There should be opposite spins. So according to Pauli's exclusion principle, let us take example of hydrogen and helium here. Electronic configuration of hydrogen is 1s1. Therefore, its principal quantum number is 1. Azimuthal number is 0, as we all know. Magnetic quantum number also will take up only the 0 value. Hence the spin, since it has got only one electron, will be plus half. But when you come to the helium, its electronic configuration can be 1s2. It cannot be in such a way that it is plus half and another plus half. It has to be one plus half and one minus half. Now if you look at this, all the quantum numbers are similar here, but the spin quantum number is differing from the rest of it, which makes helium different from that of hydrogen. So these are the references which I have gone through for these taking up these topics for you people. And thank you for watching. Have a nice time.